It's hard to conceive today, but few were noticing the varying degrees of bad sound happening at live events in the 1950s, and next to no one was doing anything about it. One that did notice, did care, and essentially gave birth to an industry is Bill Hanley. From the Newport Jazz Festivals to Woodstock, from the Beatles to Jefferson Airplane and beyond, he was the ears for a generation. Born in 1937 in Medford, Massachusetts, Hanley was attracted to electronics at an early age. Even before he was a teenager, he was experimenting with sound equipment. With his younger brother Terry, they started providing sound for church meetings and sock hops. When he got a good job at MIT's Laboratory for Electronics, he still continued his passion for sound in the evenings. It was the dark ages of professional sound, where promoters needed first to be convinced that quality sound was important. Luckily, one who was listening was Newport Jazz Festival's promoter and founder, George Ween. Building on those gigs, Hanley eventually took a tremendous leap of faith and formed Hanley Sound. Brother Terry was right there with him and recalls those early days building the speakers they needed because they didn't have enough money to buy what little was available at the time. In the early 1960s, Hanley opened a New York office and was soon providing sound for Cafe Agogo and The Bitter End. It was during this time he developed a revolutionary four-driver loudspeaker. Also during this period, a big break came when Beach Boy Brian Wilson turned to Hanley to mix the band's sound. Next, he was called on to provide the sound for the Beatles' historic second U.S. tour. Yet his knowledge, equipment, experience, and genius could not compete with his Altec Lansing speakers, strategically placed, powered by an impressive 600-watt amplifier system, was neutralized by the 135 dB of white noise that 42,000 screaming girls can create. "I didn't have a snowball's chance in hell," Bill recalls later with a laugh. Legendary promoter Bill Graham trusted Hanley to do the sound at the Fillmore East. Other gigs of note include President Johnson's inaugural and the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. The innovations just kept coming. Working with Neil Young on a Buffalo Springfield tour, Hanley pioneered a monitor system that could be positioned in front of the artist without causing feedback. Then, in 1969, he was the first one to use CM chain motors to hang a speaker array for a Rolling Stones concert. Promoter Michael Lang then asked him to do the sound for the defining live event of our time, Woodstock. "There was no one who had ever done something like that before," Lang said. Then there was this crazy guy in Boston who wanted to take a shot at it. Hanley picked the location, the crew, designed and supervised speaker placement, and even handled the master recording. It was an historic success. In the 1970s, he would follow his conscience and put his skills to use for many anti-war rallies, even once getting arrested for his efforts. From there, he continued to do live sound events, continued to influence and innovate, and still today, there's no shortage of those wanting to honor him and thank him. Bill Hanley, father of Festival Sound.